This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com.
Dear students, in the previous two sessions of coordination compounds, I talked about mononuclear coordination compound. In this session, I am going to talk about polynuclear coordination compound. How to write the IUPAC name of a polynuclear coordination compound. But first of all, what is polynuclear coordination compound? If the complex contains two or more central metal atoms, then it is termed as polynuclear complex. For example, NH3, whole 5, CO, NH2, CO, NH3, whole 5, and outside the square bracket, NO3, whole 5. Here you can see one cobalt here, one cobalt here. That is why it is polynuclear coordination compound. Point is clear? Dear students, we already know that while writing the name of coordination compounds, first we write the name of the cation, then we write the name of the anion. Now, depending upon whether cationic part is complex or anionic part is complex, we write the name. And while writing the name of the complex part, first we write what? Names of the ligands alphabetically, then we write the name of the central atom, then we write oxidation state in the Roman numeral inside the bracket. Okay, now when it is bridging ligand in the polynuclear coordination compound, you will find bridging ligand. In this case, this NH2 is the bridging ligand. So the bridging ligands which link the two metal atoms together are indicated by prefix mu. The normal name of this NH2 is amido, but now it is bridging ligand, so name will be what? Mu amido. Mu amido will be the name of this bridging ligand. The point is clear? Now, rule number next. This third rule says, if there are two or more bridging ligands of the same kind, then this is indicated by dimu, trimu, etc. For example, if I write CO3 FE CO3 FE CO3, so basically these three carbonyl groups are actually bridging ligands. So for that I will say trimu carbonyl. What will you say? Trimu carbonyl. My point is clear. Now next point. This fourth rule says bridging groups are listed alphabetically with the other groups unless symmetry of the molecule allows simpler name. I'll tell you, if it is like this metal bridging ligand, let us say OH, here let us say NH2. So this is mu hydroxo, this is mu amido. Now we have to write the name alphabetically. So first you have to write mu amido, then mu hydroxo. This point is clear? Now fifth point. It says if the bridging group bridges more than two central atoms, please note here you see the bridging ligand is bridging how many atoms? Central atoms, two. So it says if more than two central atoms are there, then it is written as mu3, mu4, mu5, etc. Mu3 if it bridges 3 central atoms, mu4 if it bridges 4 central atoms. Getting the point? Now I'll take few examples to understand these rules. Dear students, consider this coordination compound, polynuclear coordination compound. This is a simple example of polynuclear coordination compound. This is the bridging ligand. First of all, find the oxidation number of the central atom. Here NS3 charge is 0, 0 into 5 plus let us say X, and NH2 charge is minus 1 plus here X plus 0 into 5 is equal to 5. So X comes as how much? 2X is equal to 6, so X comes as 3. Now to write the name of this polynuclear coordination compound, the rules are very simple. First you have to write the name of cation. Then you have to write the name of anion. Anion is a simple anion, so name will be nitrate. Cation is a complex part. Complex, while writing the name of the complex part, we write ligands first. Then we write central metal. Then we write oxygen state inside the bracket in Roman numeral. Okay, now in this case, since it is polynuclear complex, we write name in a very simple manner. First, we write the name of this part. Then we will write mu amido, then we will write the name of this part, and then simply nitrate. So what is the name of this part? Pentaamine. Pentaamine cobalt 3. 3 is the oxidation number. So I will write this pentaamine cobalt 3. No space here. It is mu amido. Then again the name of this part, that is penta amine cobalt 3, and then simply nitrate after giving the space. Okay, now if you look at this polynuclear complex, this part and this part, these two parts are same, identical parts. So there is one more way of writing the name of this type of polynuclear coordination compound. We can use BIS instead of writing this two times. My point is clear. In that case, you have to write this mu amido first. Write mu amido and then BIS. This, and inside the bracket you write penta amine cobalt 3, bracket closed, and then outside you write nitrate. So here we are getting two ways of writing the IUPAC name of this type of polynuclear coordination compound. Okay, now I'll take one more example here. Here the complex given is CO3Fe. This is carbonyl group, and then three bridging ligands of same type, then CO3. Now you can see this part and this part, both are same, so we can use this. At the same time, there are three carbonyl groups, bridging ligands. So you have to use tri. So I will write tri mu carbonyl and then bis, and inside the bracket I'll write tricarbonyl. I'll write the name of this part. Tricarbonyl, because three CO group, and then this is what? Neutral complex. And for positive and neutral complexes, we simply write the name of the central metal. And for anionic complexes, the name ends with ATE. Here we will not write ferrate. Here we will write simply iron. And oxidation number, if you find, carbonyl charge is 0. Everywhere it is 0. So oxidation number will come as 0. So this is the name of this coordination compound. Now another example, Be4OCH3COO whole 6. Okay, this is oxo, this is oxo, and this is acetate. The compound is actually basic beryllium acetate. Okay, but as a ligand, we will name this as acetato, and this is oxo. So name will be what? First of all, 6CH3CO minus present. That is why I will write hexa mu acetato. And this oxo is actually attached with four central atoms. That is why we will write mu4 oxo, and then tetra beryllium 2. Point is clear. Oxidation state you can easily find. Let us say x is the oxidation number of B, so it will be 4x, and O oxo is minus 2 and plus, and CH3CO is minus 1, total 6, so it will be minus 6 is equal to 0, and this way the value of x comes as 2. And that is why I have written 2 in the bracket in Roman numeral. So this is all about the polynuclear coordination compound. Thank you.
This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Testprepadda.com provides free audio-visual lectures of different subjects by expert faculties, free online tests prepared by expert faculties to students who are preparing for engineering or medical entrance exams or planning to take exams like KVPY, Olympiad, etc. It provides a platform where students can interact with mentors to improve their performance in the exams. The mission of this online medium is to help students to achieve their goals. Log on to www.testprepadda.com to watch free video lectures on different topics, to download free revision notes, to take free chapter-wise online tests, progressive test, and mock test, to discuss doubts with mentors. Thank you for watching the video. To stay up to date with the latest videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like us on our Facebook page, Test Prep Adda. All the best.